everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we are finally talking about rosewood fragrances. Finally. I feel like this will be a longer video, so definitely grab a cup of coffee, grab a cup of tea, grab a snack, a glass of wine, whatever you like, and let's talk about some of my favorite notes, rose and wood. So guys, I hear on the internet a lot of times that do you really need another rosewood combo? And I started to think, and I started to see that a lot of people assume that all rosewood combos smell the same, which is not true, by the way, it's not true at all. And this brings me to my next point, guys. I feel like a lot of people don't know how wood actually smells like. And that's not a problem, we are all here to learn, I am myself learning. But I was thinking about doing a video in which I talk about the different kind of wood that you can find in fragrances and about the rosewood combos that I have tried, and I will do like a mini, like a short review for that one. Just like not all roses smell the same, not all wood out there smell the same. First of all, you have your natural wood, then you have your synthetic wood. Synthetic wood, it's a compound made in the lab, okay? Natural wood, guys, you can find it in certain places on the globe. And depending on where you get your wood from, it will have a certain scent profile. For instance, like Hindi wood, you know, is the most pungent, it's supposed to be the most difficult, challenging wood. While you have other ones that are sweeter, smoother, so on and so forth. This is not just about wood. I will leave the natural versus synthetic discussion a bit aside, and I will focus now on scent profile. From what I have tried so far, I have come across five types of wood. I don't like all of them, and I will let you know why when you get to that certain wood. The five types of wood smell or scent profile that I have came across are your medicinal wood, your woody kind of wood, your barnyard shitty smelling wood, your resinous wood, and then your very pungent, fermented, puke-like kind of wood. And just like that with roses, you have a lot of roses. You have some that are more light and fresh, you have some that are more fruitier, you have some that are heavier, darker. You have a lot of roses, basically. I feel like when people say that they are tired of rosewood combos, I feel like they are talking about two categories. They are either talking about that rose plus patchouli DNA, that's very cold, dark, but it has that common DNA, rose plus patchouli. And a lot of cases that doesn't have any wood in it. It has woody notes, but it doesn't have wood. Or they are either talking about that typical Latafa / Ardel Zafran DNA that you find in all of these fragrances here. I'm not saying that all of these smell alike. I am just saying that all of these share common nuances. So if you've tried few of these, you already know what I'm talking about. Let's start with the category I hate, which is medicinal wood. And how I would describe medicinal wood. To me, medicinal wood smells like a very synthetic, very fake smelling cleaning / disinfectant product. And unfortunately, guys, you will find this rose plus medicinal wood combo in a lot of fragrances. A lot of fragrances. Designer, niche, or even Middle Eastern brand. I will let you know the ones that I have came across that have that medicinal wood plus rose mix. I will let you know my thoughts about them, and then we will move on to the next types of wood. So guys, the first one is from Rasasi, and it's called Mukhalatu del Mubakar, and I hate it, honestly. I'm not gonna go and bring the bottle, but I will insert a picture of the bottle here. First of all, that one is heavier on the rose than on the wood. But second of all, that fragrance smells like a very cheap and synthetic rose-scented air refreshener, plus like some disinfectant products mixed together. And that's the fragrance that you have. It can be very headache-inducing. To me, it smells very cheap. I mean, if you have it and you enjoy it, it's okay. I don't enjoy it. I find it very headache triggering, and even though, like, generally speaking, I don't have headaches from fragrances, but that one, guys, I find that one just gives me a lot of headaches. So yes, guys, like I said, cold rose scented air refreshener with a underlying nuance of like a disinfectant. That's what I get from it. I do not enjoy it. I would not recommend it. Let's move to the next one. So guys, the next one comes from the brand of Montar, and I'm talking about Oud Damascus. Again, it has that DNA as well. It's just stronger and it projects better because it's from Montal, and you know Montal fragrances. It's not my favorite. I mean, again, cold rose fragrance plus that wood that has this underlying cleaning disinfectant product vibe. Not my kind, not my cup of tea. If you enjoy it, you do you. I do not enjoy it. So next one, guys, if you have this set, this one is from Al Haramain. If you have this set, just so you know, you will find it here as well, unfortunately. Yeah, this one, yes. The same problem, guys, is this one. If you have this set, you have one in here as well. Like I've told you, it's a very common rosewood combo found, unfortunately. But to me, guys, why I don't like it is because it smells very cheap and synthetic, and I feel like, guys, once you've smelled a rose scented air freshener and then you've smelled any kind of cleaning disinfectant product, you will get that same vibe. Okay, guys, so the fourth one that has a slight medicinal vibe, this one, this time it's not like a full-blown oud, medicinal oud, but it has a slight medicinal oud nuances, is from Armand, and it is called Shade Wood. That again is a cold, spicy with slight herbal nuances woody wood fragrance. I enjoy it. Unisex, it might be a little bit more masculine, but I enjoy it. It's not my favorite, it's not my favorite rosewood combo. It's not the one that I always go gravitate towards, no, but it's one that it's actually enjoyable. Now guys, let's move on to the woody kind of wood. This one, again, you will meet in a lot of fragrances, no matter if it's niche, if it's designer, if it's Middle Eastern brand, no matter the price, you will meet this one a lot. Personally, this is my favorite kind of wood because it is the most enjoyable one. Think of it like a slight amped up woody nuance that's a bit richer, and that's how I describe the woody kind of wood. The first one I want to mention is by one of my favorite brands, guys, when it comes to fragrances, is by Swiss Arabian, and I'm talking about Oud Aswad. That means black wood, and basically, guys, with that one you have a very juicy rose in the beginning, plus some slight spicy nuances, plus a bit of leather. But do not be fooled, do not be fooled, because that one quickly transforms into a rose scented incense stick that's burning. That's the smell you will get from this one if you use it on your skin and on clothes as well, but it will get to that stage a bit in a bit more time. If I were to describe, it's my signature fragrance, guys. If I were to describe it in a one word, I would say it smells opulent. It smells like opulence, guys. Don't be fooled, because you see there in the nose breakdown vanilla. This is not a vanilla wood combo for sure. Now guys, the next one that I want to mention is by Jo Malone, and it is called Velvet Rose and Wood, but it's not their regular one, it's their rich extract version. That one, I have it in my collection. I have like 10 ml, 15 ml left. That one, guys, is one of my most long-lasting fragrances. It doesn't project as much, guys, but like that one just lasts and lasts and lasts on my skin. Oh my gosh, guys, I feel like that one is the most long-lasting fragrance that I have on my skin in my collection. Too bad it was a limited edition. I don't think you can find it, or if you can find it, it's like ridiculous prices. So yes, guys, basically that one, again, you have a cold dark velvety rose mixed with a woody kind of wood, and you have there a bit of sweetness. But it's not a sweet fragrance. That one to me is a very gothic fragrance. It's dark, it's mysterious, like I said, a bit more gothic. But it's beautiful and it's very wearable. And again, that one is heavier on the rose than on the wood. The wood is there, guys, to just give the fragrance depth and a bit of complexity and a bit of richness to the smell, you know. So, next one. Guys, let's talk about another one of my favorites, which is from Swiss Arabian as well. And I'm talking about Sharaf Oud, the gold one. That one, guys, again, you have the rose, you have the oud, but that one is a very different take on rose oud combo. they took it into a gourmand category because you have a very, very sweet praline note that is very heavy. It's very noticeable in that fragrance. And I feel like that fragrance is that, and that one to me, guys, it's more heavy on the praline and on wood than it's on rose, if that makes sense. But it also, it has some slight woody, smoky nuances. I get them on my skin, on the test strip I don't get them. But yeah, that one is a beautiful fragrance to me. I mean, personally, I find it leans a bit more feminine. But actually, my best friend, who's not into fragrances at all, and she's not into Middle Eastern fragrances, to her, that one actually leans more masculine. So, I mean, I'm just telling you as a reference. Next typical rosewood combo, guys, is by the house of Guerlain, and I'm talking about Santal Royal. It's a beautiful fragrance. I mean, but then again, this is called the rosewood combo, but to me, that one is heavier on sandalwood than on wood. And then you also have some leather there, but it's a beautiful fragrance. What can I tell you? It absolutely is a gorgeous fragrance. I will do a review about it, so I don't want to say a lot about it. If you've been interested in that fragrance, just so you know that on my skin, it has this underlying nuance, or it has this underlying smell of ashy cigars, which I love, but it's very prominent. So if you're not into smoky, ashy, cigar-like smells, I don't think you would enjoy it, because even though in the opening it's different, you don't get that, but then in the dry down on your skin, to me, that's the most prominent aspect I get. But personally, I love smoky accords, I love everything. I love the smell of cigars. I'm not a smoker personally, but I love the smell of cigars. Let's move on to a fragrance that I absolutely love. I only wear it to very special occasions, but it is one of my favorite fragrances, and this time it is by the House of Ajman. I'm sure you, if you watch my videos, you can already tell which one it is, but I'm talking about Rosewood by Ajmal. It is from their W series, like the Wood series. They have a lot of fragrances in that line. Like I've mentioned plenty of times, that is my favorite line from them. They all smell luxurious, they all smell amazing, and they smell very elegant at the same time. Now, if I were to describe how this fragrance smells, it smells like a strong, confident woman that's very luxurious at the same time. So this is luxury in a bottle to me. In my opinion, this is more on the feminine side than on the masculine, but this, again, this is just for reference, you do what you want. This is a rose wood combo. The wood here, like all the fragrances that I have mentioned in this category, it has this woody underlying touch to it. So it's not a pungent wood, it's not a barnyard, it's not a difficult to wear kind of wood. It's a very enjoyable and easy to wear kind of wood, like I've said, which is my favorite one. Guys, I feel like if I were to recommend you a fragrance, if you want to invest and you want to get into the rosewood combos, but with a Middle Eastern touch, I think this is the one that I would advise you to start your collection with. Because to me, this is class and sophistication in a bottle. It smells very luxurious, but it's not in your face. I mean, it's the kind of fragrance that it will turn heads, but with good looks, no one will say who stinks or like who smells so bad, who smells so strong, you know? I have a review for this one, guys. It is one of my older videos, but still I have it on my channel. So if you're interested in that fragrance, check that review out. What can I tell you? Very luxurious. To me, it's worth the money. Honestly speaking, guys, to me, it's worth the money. I know it's more of an investment, but again, if you want it for special occasions, to me, it's absolutely worth the money. I'm very happy to have it in my collection. You don't see it a lot mentioned. Also, guys, it's more of a pricey fragrance. This is why I don't mention it that much, you know, because I always say that when it comes to more pricier fragrances, guys, you cannot just count on the reviewer's thoughts about the fragrance, you know? You need to get your own feel of the fragrance, you need to smell it, you need to test it, because it's an investment, guys. And just like with every fragrance, I know every fragrance is an investment, some bigger than the others, but when I'm talking about big investments in fragrances, never ever count just on the reviewer's thoughts about the fragrance, because keep in mind, we all smell fragrances in our own way, you know? So that's it. Next fragrance, guys, it is by Mabusan and it's called Promise Me Intense. If you were to search it on Fragrantica, you see that it has three notes listed: lychee, rose, and wood. And you might be tempted to think that you will get this sweet, fruity touch with a very dark, juicy, velvety rose and with a very warm wood. It's not that, not at all. It's a very tricky fragrance because it's definitely not what I expected. I enjoy it, but it's not my easy reach. To me, it's more of a mature fragrance. The wood is there, in the background, a bit synthetic if you ask me, but it's there, it smells decent. It's more on the mellow side, it's not very strong. But what I find, it has a very particular vibe to it. So I don't think that you should blend by this one. I don't think it's the best rosewood combo out there. I mean, for sure, I can guarantee you that there are better rosewood combos out there. But if you really want to try it, I mean, I guess it's worth trying it, but keep in mind you have to like fragrances that are a bit more on the mature side, because that one to me definitely has a very mature vibe. And the rose, it's not your modern rose, it's more like your a bit vintage-y leaning rose, if that makes sense. So guys, last fragrance in the woody wood category, it is Penthouse Windsor by Afnan. Actually it's by a sub-brand of Afnan, but let's say that it is by Afnan. That fragrance, guys, first of all, the main notes you will get in that fragrance are rose, raspberry, leather and wood. The overall vibe of the fragrance, guys, it's cold, and I've said it before, but to me it smells like a church with very high concrete walls. It gives me the same vibe. The rose is there, but it's a cold, dark rose. And then you have the raspberry touch that to me makes it even colder. You know, it's not a warm rose. So the overall vibe of that fragrance, it's cold. Second of all, you have the leather that's very strong. To me, it's a bit smoky. You have this like slight smoky leather nuance. And then you have wood. And you might get like a petrol undertone. Or like, petrol undertone from the fragrance, so just keep that in mind. So guys, let's move on to the last category. Let's move on to the funky, shitty woods. I only have two fragrances to show you. I mean, I have more, but they don't have the rose notes in them. So I'm just showing you those who have the rose and the shitty wood touch. Let's start with the one from Pascal Morabito. That one is called Gold Wood Edition. The bottle is a bit tacky, I'm not gonna lie, but the overall scent, it's beautiful. But that one, guys, the opening and the middle, I love it. The dry down, I hate it. Until you hit the dry down, that fragrance is superb. I mean, it smells so unique, guys. Why do I think that fragrance is very unique? Because it's very concentrated, it's very dense, it's very complex. You have rose there, a very juicy, sweet rose with a blast of spices there. Then you have sandalwood, you have cedarwood, you have wood. So it smells like there are so many notes and so many nuances that every time you push your nose to smell it, you get something different. But if I were to describe it, I would say that it smells like you are burning bahor, you are burning incense sticks. You have a bouquet of roses somewhere, you throw in some spices in the fire, like it's a very complex and interesting fragrance. Not for everybody. Again, not for everybody. But unfortunately, after the 5th to 6th hour mark on my skin, guys, I get a shitty vibe mixed with urine. And to me, guys, the only way I could put it is that if you've ever passed through a narrow street where people piss, that's the undertone you will get. And it's not just to my nose. I've actually spoke with some of you and you get that same vibe as well. Some of you don't, which by the way, you are very lucky for that, because if it weren't for that vibe in the dry down, I would wear that way more. Whatever. But the fragrance itself is beautiful. Pascal Morabito, I've only tried two fragrances from Pascal Morabito, would absolutely love to try more. But so far, I'm very impressed with the brand. So guys, the last fragrance in the shitty wood category, it's by Franck Olivier and it's called Wood Touch. Now, I am putting this one in the shitty wood category. It's not because, a disclaimer here guys, the bottle I have in my collection is the current batch that's being sold. But from my understandings and from what you guys have told me, the bottles sold prior to the reformulations were so strong and potent and so in your face So yes, to me this one is more, the bottle that I currently have, it has more of a woody undertouch with slight I don't want to say shitty vibe, but with slight barnyard nuances, but like very slight barnyard nuances, because those are very balanced with the patchouli, with orange and with rose. It's a very balanced fragrance to me. So yes, keep that in mind if you have the bottle's prior reformulation, or if you get the chance to buy a bottle prior reformulations. I'm just letting you know that one is supposed to be very strong, very in your face, very challenging. So yes guys, those were the rosewood combos I wanted to talk about in today's video. I have other wood fragrances, they don't feature the note of rose, but I have other wood fragrances, so I might be doing a part 2. If you've watched this video, you've seen I haven't mentioned pungent woods, because I don't have a pungent wood with rose. I haven't mentioned those very animalic, raw, resinous kind of woods, because I don't have that mixed with rose. So yes, if you want me to do a part 2 with other wood fragrances, please let me know. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. I want to talk more about my favorite notes of fragrances, guys. So this is why I'm thinking about doing more note-related fragrance videos. This is just the beginning. I've started with my favorite notes, my favorite combos. So I hope that by now you know that not all rosewood combos smell alike. From this entire list, I don't know, I think there are 13, 14, I'm not really sure. Only 2 have similar nuances, and they have similar nuances because they are supposed to dupe the same fragrance. That one is Golded Edition by Pascal Morabito and Oud Touch by Frank Olivier, and they have similar nuances because they're both supposed to dupe Oud Isfahan by Dior. So guys, I hope I managed to give rosewood combos a bit of justice. They are not the same, you can find them in various combos with various nuances. So yes guys, thank you so much for watching. Follow me on Instagram if you want, I will link my Instagram here. If you want to tell me anything, please put it in the comment section down below, and I promise that I will get back to you. But yes guys, thank you so much for watching, and I want to wish you an amazing day wherever you are. Bye. Mwah.